Mr. President, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to present a study about the terminal policy, which is well known, and these children, the number of them increased, so the problem it is still present. Sometimes when the child has paralytic dislocations of the hip, we don't know what to do because it is present some method which are completely various. In severe cases of cerebral palsy children, hip pulsation may occur. In this pain, secondary scoliosis and difficulty in childcare. In this group of patients, it is possible to perform supraclavicular valvulization femoral stereotomy according to chance or hip reconstruction according to data or Salter. Aim of this study is to determine the possibility of surgical treatment in paralytic dislocation of the hip. In a situation where rehabilitation treatment, botulinum injection, use of orthosis and even simple surgical procedures such as open adductor anatomy are not sufficient, surgical treatment of the femur or pelvis is necessary. Sometimes we have to decide which operation method would be the best solution for every particular patient, pelvic support osteotomy or complete reconstruction of the hip joint. In treatment of the hip pulsation in quadriplegic cerebral palsy patients level 4 and 5 in gross motor function classification system scale, we usually choose pelvic support osteotomy according to SHARS. In this study, we want to present the value of such pelvic support osteotomy. The aim of the treatment was to reduce or remove pain and to improve the child care. In years 1996 to 2011, in the Pediatric Orthopedic and Rehabilitation Department in Lublin, we have been treated 853 children with cerebral palsy. In this group, there was 124 children with paralytic hip pulsation and subluxation. In children of the first, second, and third group of this scale, level, they have performed pelvic osteotomy according to the Gasalder. It was 87 patients. In children who used to stand and walk before the luxation of the hip appeared, the reconstruction of the hip is recommended. It improves ability of standing and walking. In case of 37 non-walking or walking with support children, level 45, the subclavicular valvulization femoral osteotomy has been performed according to chance. The age of the patient was from 6.5 to 20, average 12.5, including jars and balls, together 37 hips. Femur position before and after the surgery, possibility of sitting, standing, or locomotion, pain scale, movement of the hips were analyzed. The first example is the child Alessandra. Main problems: non-walking, adduction, contraction of the left hip, child care problems. It is her X-ray made 2 years before she came to me. And it seems to be okay. And it is after 2 years, no proper hip care. And then she came to our department, to me. And we start to overtake at extension, reposition, then cast in the front supplement position. Then we switch the cast to the abduction cast. But after after 2 months, we get reluxation. So we were thinking what to do with a support osteotomy or the normal reconstruction. The girl wasn't able to stand or walk, and stabilization of the head was weak. But after discussion with parents who planned that the child wants to stand and walk, we decided to make reconstruction of the hip. This is the X-ray made directly after operation. It is 2 months later, 6 months later, 1 year after surgery, the girl is able to stand. Tugel sagte, es ist ein Geist, das du auch uns support. So there are three contrast. Surgery provided proper positioning of the kid, the girl is pain-free, there are no problems with childcare, excess of spine is preserved, she is able to stand at work with walking and other support. Next example, Kasper started sharing some postage due to pain, he lost ability of standing and walking with support, adductor contracture, reconstruction of the hip decision, this is the before operation, the operation of the left hip with good effect, 5 months after surgery, 15 months after surgery, other hip still insufficient coverage, still the same situation, so we decide to make ultrasonic osteotomy of the other side. So the first was reconstruction, so the second also we made reconstruction, and this is 2 years after surgery of the left hip, 4 months after surgery of the right hip. Next pictures, and this is present view, the body is walking with walker, rehabilitation in progress, he's using right abduction of those. Now some examples for support osteotomy. Non-walking 12 years old boy, Christian, main problems, painful movement of the both hips, childcare problems, sitting problems. It is the start X-ray. Big problems with childcare, while his legs were crossed. So we decided to make this support osteotomy. The movement improved, childcare was better, but he was still, the other hip was still painful, so we decided to make another support osteotomy, and it is no pain, childcare possibility increased, walk, and he even starts walking with walkers. The next, example of support osteotomy, Martina, it is girl 12 years old, non-walking, first admitted to our clinic, previous treatment and sufficient. Main problem, painful movement of the left hip, sitting problems, scoliosis, which were progressing, childcare problems. I show the place where the pain came from. 6 weeks after support osteotomy, 3 months after surgery, gel can sitting, spine is getting straight. For 6 months after surgery, 9 months after surgery, now the blade is removed and she is very happy, no pain, sitting without problems. Girl started to stand, which stand up as it did, decrease of the scoliosis, no childcare problems. One more example, 11 years old boy, Jakub, non-walking, main problems, painful movement of the left hip, scoliosis, childcare problems. Preoperative view, first the left femur, 6 weeks after surgery, 7 months after surgery, then we make the right hip was still painful, so we made another osteotomy. It is 6 weeks after right hip osteotomy, 9 months after right, 1.5 years after left femur surgery. Less pain, increased sitting possibilities, started to stand up assisted, decrease of the scoliosis, no childcare problems. The study shows that reconstruction operation is successful if the child has contact with parents when stabilization of the head and spine is sufficient. Then it is chance to walk for child painless. The study of support osteotomy shows that all children's adductor and flexion contractions have been improved from 10 to 50 degree adduction contraction postoperatively, up to 15 to 45 of the adduction postoperatively, and from 20 to 70 flexion contraction prior up to full extension postoperatively. not very close operatively reaching from the pain preoperatively reaching from 6 to 10 pulse in 10 pulse scale down to 3 to 6 pulse in 6-8 pulse post-operatively. As of all the children grown, child care possibility has improved. In children who can had used to stand and walk before luxation of the hip appears, the reconstruction of the hip is recommended. It restores anatomic structures and allows to a painless, stable standing and walking. Shunt osteotomy is effective in the improvement of comfort of living among children with severe cerebral palsy syndrome. Pelvic support osteotomy is an available method of pain reduction treatment. The possibility of childcare of operated children was improved. In some cases, the both method improvement inspired access and pelvic for care. Thank you very much for your attention. And I would like to invite you to Lublin. It is next May, we have Polish Society of Orthopedic Children's Orthopedic Society, the meeting, which the main topic is growing zone country. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for this presentation and papers for discussion.
Thank you. Yes, it's a nice presentation, but the new cases, I think the problem is not in the head. The problem is in the femur, the relation between the neck and the femur. Because such patients have a powerful adductor muscle, and weak adductor, which is mis-genomous. And all the time, adductor muscle is contracted, and this leads to coxavalga. And there is a hip shaft angle is diminished because there is no actual angle. And the problem, I think, is not to do pelvic osteotomy, but to do proper femoral osteotomy. Not only in one plane, I mean, varus osteotomy, but it needs varus and rotation in order to correct the anti-version gear and bring the head in front of. This acetabulum is more or less normal. It needs nothing to increase. It's not a displacement. Just we need the head to enter the acetabulum again. And the problem also in muscle. Either you augment the abductor muscle by transport of any or to increase the angulation of the femur. This is only my
comment. Thank you very much for the comment. And I can only tell you that in reconstruction of osteotomy, we do the correction of the torsion every time. We know about this is, but sometimes on the X-ray it looks that it is immobilization of the femur. As true, it is immobilization, it's only under torsion. It's too much under torsion, so the dead torsion is, we must do it, and we are doing it, but because perhaps I don't press this point. Other thing is that this support osteotomy, it is for very strong illness. It is not for walking child. And in every method, we make a shortening, which is also very important to make a better movement.
Some also recommend transfer of adductor muscle. Release adductor from this trochanter and transfer it to the tip of greater trochanter laterally in order to act as adductor instead of weak rotations and movements. Do you have some experience with such
movement? No, we didn't play such transfer, but it seems very interesting. I must look at it carefully. Thank you.
Professor, I mean, you have experience with Professor
Switcher. Sir, you have experience with this, you mentioned this transposition from trochanter major through, and do you know through iliac ring, iliopsoas muscle, съвършенно усро реакпинг ту прокадер мейджер. Is it true?
Unfortunately, yes, it is true, but unfortunately I have no experience in such transfer. But I looking if there is a center for pediatric surgery, like I know center of Professor Karski, Jesse Kangelski, advised to go to this transfer and study. I think give you a good opportunity. Thank you.
I think that with all patients with cerebral palsy, these indications for such procedure have to be strong individual, because depends on psychic, psychological state of patients, of parents, and the age of children, and some the main cause. It means the neurologic disease. It is what should be treated at the first place. Surgery is the last of a symptomatic way of treatment, and all these procedures where are indicated, it has to be very seriously thinking about it and indicated, because some procedure anatomical result is very good, but functional result is very bad, and it needs to have long experience with these children. And I think Jacek is very educated in this problematic and experience, and indications are it is not hobby, but it is the art of orthopedic surgery to indicate right surgery.
I would like to add that the cooperation with parents and the child is, I think, the most important. And these children, we decided to make supporters for me. Most of them came not from their own home, but from the special hospital where they have all day care and they are living forever. And the teachers asked us to remove pain and improve child care. And it can be made with this method. The other positive, or perhaps very big positive of this method, is that it is forever. When we make this operation, it will not get worse. It is stable good. So it is really, really, really good operation.
Thank you very much. The last question,
please. Yeah, whisper. Скажите, пожалуйста, использовали вы укорачивающие резекции бедра в случае, когда вы вешались на максимальном отделе? Это первый вопрос. Второй. Какая иммобилизация после операции и ее сроки?
Укорачивание каждый раз при реконструкции мы использовали
sometimes not all, but the piece of the part, the half, and in this support osteotomy we make a little bit shortening, because this method make functional shortening itself, so it's not very necessary. With this embolization, we use, so during operation, we just use the band to keep the blood without bleeding. I do not use very often this electro muscle or something like this. And after operation, we just, you know, with this child, the child is normally without any problems with bleeding, it stopped itself in
No. Фиксация после операции.
the cast, plaster of Paris.
Gipsy повязки, что-то вот там.
Fixation and locking.
Yes, we use the cast. Just cast, plaster of Paris.
How long?
How long? 6 weeks. 6 weeks.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Hans. Thank you, Jacek, for your outstanding presentation. And now I apologize, we are late with presentations. It is my mistake, and that is why we have to go